We know that light is a form of energy. Light can come from natural as well as man-made sources. Which are the natural sources of light? Sun, stars, fire are some of the natural sources of light. Which are the man-made sources? Electric bulb, CFL bulb, LED bulb are man-made sources of light. Let me take this torch and flash it on the wall. You can see the flashlight on the wall, but how about the path from battery to the wall? I don't see any light in the path. Let me hold this pen at some places in the path and check if light is really present there as well. Yes, light is present wherever I place a pen. Pen shines in certain areas due to light from the battery. I can create some smoke in the room and we can clearly see the whole path. This is the path light travels from battery to the wall. Light bounces off tiny particles of smoke and is reflected back into our eyes. That is how we see things. Light reaches our eyes and due to biochemical reactions in our eyes, we can see things or we can feel light. Objects can be seen only when light is present. Let me light this candle. If I place this glass in front of the candle, I can still see the candle. Light passes through the glass. Glass is called transparent object. Let me place this paper, metal sheet, acrylic sheet, duster as well. All these objects stop light from passing through it. These objects are called opaque objects. Let me place this frosted glass in front of the candle. I can see the candle, but not very clearly. Same is true with this butter paper. These are called translucent objects. A translucent object lets light pass through, but objects on the other side can't be seen clearly. Sun is a natural source of light. Sunlight travels a very long distance before reaching Earth. During this journey, it travels through space before entering Earth's atmosphere. Do you know what consists of Earth's atmosphere? It contains lots of gases and other tiny particles. During its travel from Sun towards Earth, sunlight bounces off these tiny particles. Sunlight is scattered after it hits these tiny particles. We have seen that white light is a combination of different colors with the help of a prism. When sunlight hits these tiny particles, blue light is scattered the most. That is the reason we see blue sky. We will make a square tube from this plastic sheet. When we burn this incense stick, lots of smoke is generated. We will collect the smoke in the plastic container. It contains particles similar to the ones in the Earth's atmosphere. Let us place this on the torch, which emits white light. You can see the blue tinge of light in this container. This is very similar to the color of the sky. It happens because blue light is scattered most by these tiny particles. We learned about sound waves in the previous standard. Light is another form of wave. Light waves can be classified into two categories: visible light waves and invisible light waves. Length is a measure of distance. This pencil is 15 cm long. Dimension of this pencil can be described by length. Waves are described by wavelength. When light comes from the sun, all these light waves of different wavelengths travel through empty space. When they reach Earth's atmosphere, the light waves can interact with particles in the air like dust, water droplets, and ice crystals. Because of the extremely small size of visible light waves, these light waves also interact with the tiny gas molecules that air has. The light waves bounce off these particles just like you might collide and bounce in some direction in a crowded place. As the light waves bounce in lots of different directions, we say they have been scattered. How light waves get scattered depends strongly on the size of the particle compared with the wavelength of the light. Particles that are small compared with the light wavelength scatter blue light more strongly than red light. Because of this, the tiny gas molecules that make up our Earth's atmosphere scatter blue portion of the sunlight in all directions, creating an effect that we see as a blue sky. Within the visible range of light, red light waves are scattered the least by atmospheric gas molecules. So, at sunrise and sunset, when the sunlight travels a long path through the atmosphere to reach our eyes, the blue light has been mostly removed, leaving mostly red and yellow light remaining. The result is that the sunlight takes on an orange or red tinge, which we can see reflected from clouds and other objects as a colorful sunrise or sunset. We will do another activity to see this effect. I will fill this plastic water bottle with water. Let us keep this bottle on the torch. You can see the white light from the torch. When I put some milk in the water, it becomes slightly turbid. Small particles of milk are similar to the ones in the atmosphere. You can see the blue tinge in some areas of the bottle. Summary. Light is another form of energy. We looked at natural as well as artificial sources of light. Objects through which light passes are called transparent objects. Objects through which light cannot pass are called opaque objects. A translucent object lets light pass through, but objects on the other side can't be seen clearly. We discussed about scattering of light and how it plays a role in deciding the color of the sky during different times of the day. Try these activities with some variation and discuss findings with your friends.